Welcome to Soft Reviewed. In this video, I am going to show you a new website that is a Midjourney alternative. Now, this is my favorite tool where I go to create AI art and AI images for free. This is my new favorite Midjourney alternative, and their free plan is really great. I am not sure how long they will keep this free plan, but when you log into their website, as you can see, you cannot directly sign up for the website. For that, you have to actually give your email here and just click on the count me in. And once you do that, you will get an email from them saying that you need to go to their Discord server and introduce yourself in the Discord server. Then only you will get access to this website. So that's how the sign up process works. This is how the Discord server will look like, and you can see the roles here. And for the introduction, you can go here and introduce yourself. Then you will get a mail saying that you got access and you can just log in. So that's how you log in. Let's just look at the FAQs just for a second, and we will have generous free tier doing the alpha testing, and they are just initially only offering this free service only in the testing phase, I guess. So once they roll out their original product, then there won't be any free service. So it's better to use it when you can, and the software is really great. I really like it. That's the only thing you need to actually care about. And now let's look at how the actual app looks like. Once you are logged in, you can see this interface where you can see the featured models here. So if you click on the here on the fine-tuned model, you can see all the models that's available here. And you can also like favorite your models so that it will be accessible once you go to the AI image generation here. So when you favorite it, it will be easily accessible in this area, which I'll show you later. So these are some of the best models that they have, and I like all of these models. Six models are really great for like image generation, for face generation, and these are the models that's available with Leonardo. And you also have a section where the community members are contributing to this model. This is the greatest feature that I really like. As you can see, they have a lot of variations, and this keeps on growing. And you have like an option to do whatever you want with this. So you can see that you have like an infinite number of new models that coming up all the day. So this is the greatest feature that I like with this website. And here is where you, this is where you find your models, and you can also favorite your models here, where you can access your all your favorite models from here. And you can also sort it by category like this. They have like general building and things like that. And you also have the option to sort from new and the image generator and name, things like that. So this is one of the standout feature of the software. And then you have the community feed, where you can see what are the images the community is working on right now. And when you actually click on it, you can actually see the prompt, which is really great if you want to actually work with it. And if you want, you can download it and you can upscale the image, or you can just unzoom the image. And you can all see all the data here, the resolution and the model that's used for creating this image, which is like Dream Sharper 3.2. and if you want to follow this person, you can also follow him. And this is, if you want to remix, you can just click on it and it will copy all the in the image editor. This is how the image editor looks like. It copy all the information that that image had, and you can also generate your own variation based on that. So if we go back, that's that functionality. So if I click on this image, for example, if I just click on this, I can create variations of the image. This function is called image to image. where, as you can see, that image is added here as the seed image, and you can create variations of the same image like that. I'll just show you one variation. We can just select one number of image and let's just click on generate. As you can see, you will get 250 tokens to work with every day, and this resets every day, so you have like 250 tokens to play around, which is more than enough. You can create like 50 or 100 images if you are just using this for fun. So as you can see, it generated a variation of this image. So, and you can also unzoom the image. What it means is like you can change the camera angle and make it like a bit more unzoomed so that it will cover more area of that image. As you can see, this is the unzoomed image and this is the original image. So it just zoom out, the camera will just go backward. That's this effect. And if you want, you can download the image here, and I'll just delete it. Just showing you this, I'll just go here and I'll show how we get here. When you click here, you can just click on the AI image generation, and these are some of the images that I work with. And as you can see, I have used the same prompt. You can see the prompt that you used, and you can see the negative prompt here, and you can also see the style that's used, and you can see the resolution. If you click on these three dots, you have the option to generate again and view the information, and you can also copy the seed for the image as well, and you can also delete it. So I'll just show you like with this single prompt that I created, I used this Leonardo style, which you can actually choose from this drop down, and the same prompt I used with this Leonardo select, that's another variation of this, and then I used Leonardo creative, which is another variation, and the prompt, as you can see, it's all same, and it's generating different images based on that style that we select. And this is the character portrait, and this is like the dream shaper 3.2. this is also dream shaper 3.2, and this is deliberate 1.1, and this is RPG 4.0. so these are like some of the models, and you also have stable diffusion 2.1 as well. If you go to the previous images that I selected, you can see this some more images. For example, if you click on it, you can see it's Leonardo select. One issue that I faced while working with this is it's really great when it comes to the face. I really like it, but as you can see, if you really look closely, the fingers are really not coming up that great. But if you guys have any like tips or tricks to fix that, please post that in the comment below. So these are some of the images that I use the same prompt for all of this, and I selected different styles and generated all these images. So that's how you do it. So I played around with quiet a while, and you can also have the option to toggle this not safe for work, which is like really 18 plus images. So I don't have anything like that in here, but if you're follow somebody else, you can see that here. And if you have liked anyone else's image, you can see that here in the personal feed. Here is where you can actually train your own model. You can just click on add data set. I will just give it a demo, and you can give a description as you want, and you can just click on create data set. And you can actually drop like a minimum 15 images that looks same, and you can add up to 30 images to train a really good data set. And once you upload, you can just submit and you can monitor your job status. Once it's ready, you will get an email like your training is done. So always try to keep all the images like similar in style so that this model will be trained really accurately. So that's the other feature that I have not seen anywhere else. This is the main area where you can actually generate images. This is the AI image generation tool where you toggle button, which is called prompt magic, which is like a toggle button, and they are saying that it's an experimental render pipeline that might give you more accurate. Sometimes it works, but sometimes it doesn't work. So that's it. And they have like a Leonardo style as well. So these are their fine-tuned models. Before that I showed you like that you can favorite your models, and that will come here. So you can also see the resolution where it's trained, so it's better to select that resolution when you play around with that particular model there. And you also can adjust the number of images that you want to generate at a time, and you can also select the dimensions, and you can just scroll this for the, you can also select the aspect ratios, and the guidance scale is like how strongly you want the AI to follow your prompt, and step count is for like giving details. The more that you drag it here, the more details that it will have in your image, and the longer that it will take to generate. So once you figure out the right image and the right prompt that works for you, then you can actually play with the guidance scale so as to like optimize that image. So this is where you can give the image for guidance as a, you can use this as a seed. And tiling is for like if you want to repeat a pattern as background, you can use tiling feature as how the remove background works. You can just click on it and just press the button like this, and it will remove the background. As you can see now, it has got a, I think the process is completed now, and we'll just click on and see. As you can see, it removed the background. This is the original, and this one removed that background, which is like a really great feature. I really like this one. So that's how it works. And if you want to use image to image, you can just click on this, and that will be added as a seed. And now you can start working on this particular image, right? So what you can do is like, if you want to make variations, so you can like say add a sunglass, then just click on, let's click on just generate. With this first attempt, I did not get the desired result that I was looking for. Then I just changed the guidance scale to 15 from 7. And now let's look at the output. As you can see, when I moved the guidance, then so you can make changes like that. And you can also play with this guidance scale. And you can make it the images just the way you want it. And if you want to change the face also, you can just come here and just give some prompt, and you can set the guidance scale, and you can always change the face by keeping the same posture and everything like that. So another they have like a prompt generator. So if you don't know how to prompt, or you are having trouble coming up with new prompts, you can just give it a base idea. For this example, I'll give like futuristic looking sports car. That's the base prompt that I have. Now let's just click on create prompt, ideate prompt, and let's see what it can generate. So a sleek aerodynamic sports car with glossy metallic finish hovering above a non-lit cityscape. So you can just go through the prompt, and you can, if you find something interesting, you can always just go and edit this prompt, or you can just click on just generate. I'll just generate just to show you guys an example. So I'm really sorry for the quick interruption. This video is like already 14 minutes long. I'll upload the next part tomorrow. So if you like to see that, please consider subscribing and like this video if you want me to create more videos like this. and thank you for watching. Have a great day.